everybody, my name is Jenna and today we are doing another tag video. Today's tag is the Taylor Swift 3.0 book tag, The Reputation Era. Reputation is so different for Taylor Swift and I love it. I love it even more now after having watched Miss Americana because I completely misjudged where she was coming from with most of this album, but now it is something amazing and fantastic and I absolutely love it. I don't know exactly who created this book tag, but I would definitely leave a link to the original video in the description box below. So definitely go and check that out and give whoever it is some Taylor Swift lovin'. So there are 15 questions, I believe, because there are 15 songs on this album. So we are just gonna get started. Question number one. Ready for it? What is a book you were super excited to read? Frozen 2, Forest of Shadows by Camilla Benko. This is the bridge novel between Frozen and Frozen 2. And if you'll know me at all, you will know that I love and am obsessed with Frozen. So really, it is unsurprising that I was so excited to read this one. Once I found out it was a thing, I was counting down the days until it came out, bought it on the day it was released, read it all so quickly, and just so excited to read it. And thankfully, it did not let me down. This book was amazing. Question number two. Endgame. What are some of your OTPs? Like everyone, I have a lot of OTPs and I wasn't sure exactly how to narrow it down, but a few of my favorites include Alex and Caden from the Midoriya Chronicles by Lynette Noni, Magnus and Alec from the Shadowhunter Chronicles by Cassandra Clare, Harry and Ginny from the Harry Potter series by J.K. Rowling, Reese and Feyre from the Court of Thorns and Roses series by Sarah J. Maas, and Clark and Bellamy from The Hundred by Cass Morgan. There are of course a lot more, but those are just some of my top OTPs that I absolutely love and adore. Question number three. I Did Something Bad. Name a book with morally grey characters. For this one, I have gone with Zenith by Sasha Olsberg and Lindsay Cummings because Androma and her entire crew are basically space pirates. So, you know, they work for themselves and they kind of work outside of the law, but ultimately they do the right thing. Basically, this book was described as Guardians of the Galaxy, but like a female crew. And Guardians of the Galaxy, they're pretty morally grey group. So I felt these guys definitely fit into that category. You know, they ultimately, they do the right thing, but you know, what's in it for them? Question number four. Don't blame me, love me. Don't Blame Me. What's a book you recommend to everyone? Definitely Akane by Lynette Noni. I literally push this book on everyone that I can. In fact, when I was at Supernova last year, Lynette was there and I forced my sister to buy a copy of the book so that Lynn could sign it for her. And that was in November last year. And now my sister, who doesn't read, she's already up to We Three Heroes. So it's a good book, guys. You should read it. Question number five. Is it cool that I said all that? Is it chill that you're in my head? Delicate. What is a book you will never loan out to anyone? Gonna go with my entire Harry Potter collection here. At least the original copies of the books that I have, because I mean, they're original copies. They're the first print editions. And they're just really special to me. They're also falling apart, so I'm trying. I don't even read them very much anymore. I kind of need to get myself like a reading copies so I can just leave those as like display copies because they are falling apart and it's a real problem. But also I kind of have a horror story with letting these ones out. My Deathly Hallows copy that I have here is not the original Deathly Hallows copy that... It's not the original copy of the Deathly Hallows that I bought because my sister, because they were sort of our books, even though she never read them. She lent it to a friend and the friend never returned it. So yeah, never letting that happen again. Question number six. Look What You Made Me Do. What is a book that was your gateway into reading? So it was Enid Blyton and the Babysitter's Club books. Honestly, when I was younger, I would just read those on repeat because they were the books that I had. They were the ones that my parents sort of handed down to me, and Babysitter's Club books were incredibly cheap because you just bought them all at like garage sales or op shops, that sort of thing. So those are definitely the books that got me into reading. I would stay up late every night reading them and it was fantastic and I loved them and I still love them to this day, but they're definitely, we have them to blame for literally all of this. Question number seven. Yeah, I never listened to that song, so I don't know the lyrics. Solid effort. So it goes. What is a book that sucks you into a particular series or author? A Court of Thorns and Roses definitely sucked me into Sarah J. Maas's Court series, and it encouraged me to try the Throne of Glass series. And I did really like the first two books, but the third one was a bit, this is really different for me, so I've never gone back to try to reread it again. But this series in particular, this book got me into it. Like, hardcore got me into it, and I'm really okay with that because the Court series is fantastic and everyone says the Throne of Glass series is really good too, so I really do want to try it again, but I think this one might be better than Throne of Glass. Question number 8. Gorgeous. Name a book with a beautiful cover. So for this one I'm going with kind of a simplistic beautiful, and that is Because You Love to Hate Me, the anthology, the villain anthology, edited by Amory. I just think the hardcover especially just has a really subtle beauty to it, with the dark flower, with the bloody ink sort of running down it, the silver barbed leaves, this, the beautiful pinky purple. I just think it's a really stunning but subtle beauty, and I think that works really well for the villain aspect, because quite often the villains have this real subtle beauty to them, but in actuality they could kill you with like the snap of their fingers, and I sort of love that. Question number 9. Getaway Car. What is a book you've read with crime involved in some aspect? Definitely The Hate U Give by Angie Thomas. This whole book revolves around a crime. It revolves around the shooting of a black teenager by a white male cop, and the whole thing is just about this inquiry into his death and inquiry into this police officer, and it just literally the whole book is about this trial and this political crime, and it's really good and really hard to read and heartbreaking, but it's real good, and yeah, it's all about crime. Question number 10. King of My Heart, who is your book, boyfriend or girlfriend? For this question, we are going with the one, the only, the original, Draco Malfoy from Harry Potter and the Harry Potter series for J.K. Rowling. I know she herself has come out to say she finds it really disturbing when people like Draco because, you know, he's a bad dude. And he is a bad dude, but I think he could have been redeemed. He definitely could have had a redemption arc, and I'm really sad that he didn't because he's such a bad boy. But he's not even, like, really a bad guy. He's just a dude that makes bad decisions. But everything thinks fine because he's great and I do love him. Think I always will. Question number 11. Dancing with Our Hands Tied. What is a book that made you want to dance when you finished it? Although this doesn't make a lot of sense, my answer for this is The Evolution of Claire by Tess Sharp. And that is because when I finished it, I realized I'd found my favorite book of 2018. It's the first really good book I'd read in a long time. It was fantastic. It's amazing. And the idea of dinosaurs makes me want to dance. I don't know, but it's a great book. Love it, love it, love it. And I just loved the feeling I had when I finished it. I was so pumped up and excited. And I love that. And I love this book. And I love that song. I think that might be one of my favorite songs on this album because it's just so good. Question number 12. Dress. Name a book character you would want to trade wardrobes with. I don't think I could have picked a better pop vinyl if I'd tried, but I would trade places with Luna. Well, I'd trade wardrobes with Luna, and not just because she wears some awesome stuff, but also because she just has the confidence to wear whatever she wants, and she really doesn't care what other people think, and I love that about her. That's one of the things I love the most about her, actually, is that she doesn't care what other people think. She just does what is right for her and what makes her feel happy, and I love that, and I think her wardrobe is actually pretty cool. Like, who wouldn't want to wear a giant lion's head? Come on, people, think a little. Question number 13. This is why we can't have nice things. What is the most problematic book you've ever read? All the Right Places by Jennifer Niven. This book was problematic to me because of the way it dealt with its subject matter. I didn't think it dealt with it in a particularly good way. I definitely thought it was problematic in how it was handled, and it's a little bit upsetting because it does have a great premise, it has a great idea behind it, but it wasn't executed particularly well. And for that reason, it is a problematic book. that is actually being made into a movie on Netflix, so, you know, it might end up being a problematic film as well. And we all know Netflix does not need any more problematic teen dramas on its network, because it worked out so well for them the first time. Question number 14. Call It What You Want. What is a book you wish you could change the title to? I couldn't think of one. And that is because titles for books take like the longest time to come up with, and they tend to work for books, and I just couldn't think of a situation where the title would be better than the one they've already got. And question number 15. Day. What book gave you a fresh outlook on life? I've kind of talked about this a lot before on this channel, but the book that gave me a fresh outlook on life is definitely The Upside of Unrequited by Becky Albertalli. I think this book just has a really great message, and it really makes you think about life and think about who you are as a person and whether or not you're really happy, and mostly figuring out how to be happy with just who you are. That's something that this book really taught me and definitely made me sort of come away from it and go, you know what? I'm kind of a cool person and I like that. And there we go. That is the Taylor Swift 3.0 book tag, The Reputation Era. I love doing these videos because I absolutely love Taylor Swift. Reputation is a very different album from her, like I said, and it's not one that I listen to a lot. I mean, I do listen to some of the songs a hell of a lot, but I listen to others literally not at all. Like, I can count on one hand the number of times I've listened to the song So It Goes, because I really, really don't like that song. But that's the same with pretty much any album that comes out. There's always going to be at least one song that you don't like. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comment section below what your answers to some of these questions would have been, because I would absolutely love to know. If you like this video, be sure to give it a huge thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss a thing. Stay random. Bye.